It's here, it's here. It's time for Top Plays. Season 5 is alive with the sounds of dunking. I'm Sacramento Kings PA announcer Scott Moak, and here are this week's top four. Jay Canales, 22.
And that's the player introductions completed. So in just a few moments, we'll be back and ready for action.
Chris Middleton.
Great to have you with us. We are set to get you over the hump this Wednesday night with another edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hi, folks. Brian Anderson here, alongside two fantastic analysts, Grant Hill and Brent Berry at the table, and our reporter, Allie LaForce. Now let's take a look at the Kings' opening lineup. Mitchell and Monk there, the backcourt. Domantas Sabonis out there with Trey Lyles. And it's Barnes in at the three, a small forward. And for Toronto, Russell Westbrook out there with Gary Trent. Then it's Chris Middleton. Then there's Miles Turner. And it's Barnes in at the four. Oh, Grant, the playoffs are on the horizon. We're almost there. Can you taste postseason basketball?
I can taste it. I can smell it. I can feel it. There's nothing like the NBA playoffs. The level of basketball is just incredible. And lots of teams have a shot this year. So it'll be fun to see how it all plays out.
Monk, offensive rebound. And that's out of bounds. Sacramento will retain possession. And as the end of the regular season draws closer, let's take a look at the latest power rankings. You take a look at Cleveland. They're building some momentum right now and aiming for a spot in the top five.
Seeing where the Raptors are, they've surprised so many people with their ability to maintain this astonishing display of dominance. But here they are, the best team in the league late into the season.
And hitting from the mid-range here and making those times down.
And Russell right now playing heads up, looking for guys.
Mitchell deciding where to go with it. 11 feet out. No good. A bit long that time. And so it's Westbrook who will bring it up for Toronto. Their last game, a win against the Magic. Looking to carry it into this one.
Oh, my. Talk about mental toughness. The crowd was roaring against them, but they were able to focus and finish the task at hand.
Impressive to see them on the road just step up and have that kind of offensive performance.
Here's Toronto with the ball. Beyond the arc. Monk grabs the miss.
Great job of closing the space and getting a hand up.
Yeah, as good as you can do without getting a block there to defend.
Tries again. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line. And they'll give that one to Miles Turner.
Shooting for Sacramento, Malik Monk at the line for two.
The free throw drops for Monk. And Monk drops them both.
Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
Outside Barnes. Fires high post. It's rebounded by Sabonis. The Kings have gone 1 of 5 to start things off. And it's Monk missing.
And he gets a lot of points right there at the rim, but the defense determined not to give up the easy deuce there.
Good find there by Turner. He sees an opening and swiftly feeds the ready shooter.
First quarter, just about 2 minutes in. Monk passes to Lyles. On the take. And there's the slam. Dunk to finish it off.
Apparently, he didn't appreciate giving up points.
I mean, just throws it down right in the man's face. Here's Westbrook. And he drops it in from the low post.
And if you have that kind of quickness and can handle the ball that well, you're going to get off a makeable shot. Westbrook did it there.
Here's Mitchell. The rebound by Turner.
His touch has left him in this quarter. Nowhere close to the kind of output they need from him.
And that one's good. Middleton.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Pass to Monk. Let's it go. Barnes with it. Turner covering. And Turner with the block.
A ferocious shot blocker. Turner provides a sense of security to the rest of his teammates.
Trent. And it falls all over the rim and in.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
Well, he's going to just keep going now. That's early confidence for him.
Lyles' shot is good.
The defensive effort was lacking a bit, but hey, give him credit for finding a weakness there.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
Here's Turner. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Their last encounter in Sacramento.
Today's game is about effort and energy. They got crushed on the glass the last time these teams played.
Well, let's see if the lesson was learned from that loss. If they come out with the same type of effort, they can expect a similar result here.
And the three-pointer goes. Trent's got 7 points.
And that's what they want to do. Get him open looks early.
Mitchell, the pass to Monk. There's the drive. And Turner with the block. Pass to Middleton. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two.
Middleton, a talented scorer and a very dogged defender. He's accomplished a lot as a champion and a multi-time All-Star.
Chris Middleton.
And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Toronto.
Well, you got to be impressed with how selfless they've been so far. Their passing has been simply outstanding.
Well, I want to add also the damage that has been done on the inside. It's a lot of rubble in there, but they're continuing to go right at the defense.
You know, when you look at Chris Middleton, Brent, he's been a competitor every way you slice him.
No doubt worked himself into a multiple-time All-Star in the Eastern Conference and one of the most consistent small forwards in the league. Also an NBA champ. I just hope his health can hold out, B.A.
Timeout call, Sacramento.
Failing to find a rhythm offensively. Something that needs to change and change soon.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
Now here's Monk. You know, his stats have been solid, averaging around 18 and a half points a game. Pass to Sabonis. Missed inside. And here's Westbrook. He'll bring it up for the Raptors. 7-point differential. Middleton from the outside. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
Mitchell, the pass to Lyles. Back to Mitchell. And he banks in the layup. Mitchell's got his second bucket on the night.
Just owning the painted areas. If it's working, no need to change.
Turner against Sabonis. Turner, no good. The Kings shooting has not been great early. Just 27%. And he makes no mistake. Slam dunk.
Playing from behind, it's amazing he chose a dunk with that high a difficulty rating.
Yeah, no question. That was a stellar move with plenty of swagger. Oh, doing damage above the rim. That was our AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Barnes, great positioning on Harrison the putback.
Barnes. Maybe the length helping out Harrison Barnes that time to collect.
Turner against Sabonis. Turner, no good.
We'll have a hard time shaking that one off. Perfect position, plenty of space. Just clanked it.
And that one's good. Mitchell.
And why go away from attacking inside if the D has no answer for you?
Here's Middleton. After the Kings picked up a basket a moment ago. Back to Westbrook. Kicks it out to Middleton. Here's Turner. That's good. And so Middleton with the assist.
Smart bucket by Turner. Use your length and score it in close.
That's tipped. And they're on the run. And here's Westbrook from the arc. Good work defensively by Mitchell. The Kings trailing. The three from Barnes. Barnes with the rebound. Barnes has got rebound number 5 here tonight. Turner finds Westbrook. Now here's Barnes. Back to Westbrook. Inside. Shot clock at 5. Trent for 3. Sends it home from 3-point land. And now a 7-point Toronto lead.
This is what he does. Find space on the perimeter and then sink the 3.
Sacramento calls timeout.
And things are always changing throughout a game. Teams have to adjust on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team.
And a new group getting ready for the Kings. Matase's checked in for Sabonis. Murray comes in for Lyles. Dorte, he's checked in for Barnes. And Herter's subbed in for Monk. Here's Schroeder. The Kings getting their last shot to go. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
And while part of Schroeder's game is still developing, you can see the potential he possesses when he nails shots like that.
Here's Mitchell. 6 points for him. To the inside. To Tadze.
Oh, come on, B.A. I mean, where's the defense? That's just too easy.
Yeah, they got to do a much better job and help.
Yeah, we see this all too often. The team gets a huge lead, and then their guard gets let down.
Just such a terrific dunker.
Man, born to fly, that's for sure. Pass to Herter. On the wing, Murray. He shoots. Can't get his first shot of the game to fall.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
And it's good for 2. And the Raptors lead by 9.
An outstanding first quarter from the field.
And Sacramento shooting only 39% in the early going. Outside Herter. Fires for 3. McDaniels with the rebound. Toronto has gone 3 for 5 from deep so far in this matchup. And LeVert with a bucket on the assist by Poeltl. LeVert's got his 2nd bucket on the night.
Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were 4 or 5 boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked 6. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
Now here's Mitchell, and it falls for him. He's now 4 of 7 from the field.
Not just the accuracy in the quarter, it's his movement and the energy that's getting him on this nice roll.
McDaniels passes to Poeltl. And here's Schroeder outside. Knocks down the long game. Schroeder's got 5 points.
They've really built this lead on the back of their perimeter game.
Well, a lot of importance placed on outside shooting. And tonight you can see why after that kind of quarter exploding from the perimeter.
Now here's Mitchell. Give him 8 points now. Shot's no good. 8-4. He's missed 4 now. Pass to McDaniels. Outside Schroeder for 3. Back to Daniels. Outside Schroeder. 2nd chance shot. And that's 2 points on the layup.
And this defense needs to turn the screws and ramp up the intensity. They're looking a little loose out there right now.
They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
And here's Herter.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
Matase down low. He's working on Poeltl. And Matase gets it to go.
His nimbleness makes him a unique threat at the rim.
And Schroeder has got the ball here for Toronto. Leading by 12 over Mitchell. Shot's good by Schroeder. 7 points in the game.
That's feel-good moment right there. 3 of 4 so far.
Pass to Duarte. It's a one-on-one situation. Wing shot on the way. Here's Poeltl. Sacramento grabs the miss.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Shoots from 12. Here's Mitchell. And the foul is called. He missed it. So he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. That's on Jakob Poeltl.
Yeah, and you never want to let shots at the rim go uncontested.
The first one falls. Young, he's checked in for Boucher. Noel, he's checked in for Sacramento. Both free throws good for Mitchell. Young with it. Outside Schroeder. Over Mitchell. Shot's good by Schroeder. Schroeder's got nine.
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
Wow! Always fun to see point guards who can elevate above the rim like that.
Oh, a strong mindset and even stronger finish.
Well, just seeking out weaknesses in the defense and then exploiting it.
Offensive rebound, Pirtle. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Like a matador. Ole! There was no defense. That has to be one of the easier shots I've seen tonight.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift-wrapping points.
Now here's Mitchell. 12 points for him. Here's Duarte. Schroeder with a rebound.
Well, that's a shot they want just about on every possession, if they can get it. He doesn't make them all, but still very much a high percentage look.
Ooh, rejected by Noel.
And Noel in there to intimidate and does so there.
Seven seconds left to play in the first quarter. There's Herter with the three. Oh, no good on the last second attempt there. So as we end the first quarter, already a double-digit ballgame. Leading by 14. And we'll bring you the start of quarter number two when we return. If you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And from what we've seen here from the home team, what's your take so far?
Well, you have to credit their effort on the defensive end. It set the tone for this contest.
Yeah, defense has been infectious here as everybody stepping up aggressively on that end.
Toronto's gone 4 of 8 from three, a nice percentage. They've got Dennis Schroeder. Thaddeus Young out there with Jakob Poeltl. Then it's Chris Middleton, and it's LeVert in at the two guard. Got it. Schroeder's got 11 points.
Fighting through some defense right there. Schroeder showing some offensive confidence right now.
And for the Kings, Herter and Barnes fill the wings. Domantas Sabonis out there with Nerlens Noel, and it's Duarte in at the point guard position. Shot's good by Sabonis. Sabonis has got his first points of the game.
When he decides he wants to take it to the bucket, it's really hard for anyone to slow him down. You know, Brent, one thing about Domantas Sabonis, he definitely helps their offensive flow.
Yeah, he's one of the better screeners in the league. And you know this, Grant, those dribble handoff plays create so much movement, space, and rhythm to an offense. That's where Sabonis really excels.
Here's Duarte. No points yet. Shoots over Schroeder. They get it back. Sabonis. Pass to Duarte. Stolen by Young. Middleton, left side. And it's Middleton finishing it off.
Oh, man, nice jam from Middleton. The veteran swingman understands when to go after dunks like that.
Here's Herter. Ooh, and they immediately answer back with a dunk on the other end.
Hanging on the rim, just showing off.
That's how you extend the glory right there. Here's LeVert. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Sabonis has got 5 rebounds in the game. Barnes goes in.
This time Harrison Barnes using some of his physical advantages to bully the defense or at least get them on their heels.
And there's Young. That's good. On the assist from Schroeder. Schroeder's got 3 assists in the game. And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Here's Sabonis. Poeltl with the block. Out to Schroeder. Pass to Poeltl. The three ball. Young misses. The Kings have gone 3 of 5 since the beginning of the second. Herter passes to Sabonis. That one drops for him. Sabonis has got 4 points now in the quarter.
You got to keep the ball moving, and that time Herter's pass leads to an open look.
LeVert outside. Here's Middleton, and he hits it from 9 feet. And the Raptors lead by 16.
And another great assist. The offense is really clicking now.
Down low. Shot's good by Sabonis. Sabonis has got his third bucket of the night.
He's finally leaving that dismal first quarter behind him. Took him a while to get going.
And Toronto calls time here. Watch Harrison Barnes, Brent. He's a steady influence out there.
I feel like Harrison Barnes has been an example for younger players since he was, in fact, a younger player. Yeah, I mean, this guy goes about his business as a professional night in and night out.
Lyles, he's checked in for Sacramento. Monk comes in for Duarte. The Raptors have gotten 5 of 7 shots to go in the second. Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Well, even though Kevin Huerter knew early on that basketball would be his path, he said, quote, "I played baseball up until my senior year in high school just to be a kid. You work different muscle groups. Specializing in sports as an early age is not something that I really agree with. Sports are supposed to be fun." Brian?
Well, that's the truth. Something we all need to remember. Thanks, Allie. Barnes, it's good.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Huerter finds Sabonis. Pass to Barnes. And he drives in. Oh, and a vicious dunk by Barnes.
Yeah, that's up there. Harrison Barnes with momentum rises up, and that's a highlight.
Trent against Monk. Kicks it out to Westbrook. Launches it. It's rebounded by Sabonis. Sabonis has got 6 rebounds now in the game. Here's Monk. The rebound by Turner.
Well, that mid-range, Jay, usually pretty much on the money. Maybe the timing just a little bit off on that one.
Domantas Sabonis. First personal foul.
And we've heard players asking for more clarity and accountability from the officials. Brad, you think they have a point?
Well, players often ask refs to explain calls. So they also want some clarity from the league whether the refs got it right. And that information oftentimes can help them make the proper adjustments moving forward.
That one misses. The Kings have gotten 6 of 10 shots to drop in the second. Nice work. Here's Monk, and he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
First personal foul.
And for the players coming into the league, potentially set for life. But there are pitfalls you have to look out for, Grant.
So true, B.A. I mean, it's tough. You can't take all your childhood friends along for the ride with you. You've got to be cautious with new acquaintances, so it'll definitely keep you on your toes. You must make great decisions.
He sinks the second. Now here's Trent. 11 points in the game. Pass to Barnes. Gets it to go from the corner. Barnes has got 4 points this quarter.
And just executing at a high level. I mean, taking what the defense allows and putting in the work.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but its importance to a team showing up here, running plays that turn into scores.
Too easy for Turner. The defense has to put up more of a fight around the rim.
The Kings have gone 7 for 11 in the second quarter. Trent against Monk. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Turner. Monk for three. Sinks it from distance. Monk's got 10 points in the game. Toronto's gone 0 for 2 from outside in the second quarter. To the paint, Westbrook. And finished off by Westbrook.
Just taking it right to the defense and in their face, Westbrook at the rim.
Pass to Barnes. And Chris Middleton gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul of the game.
Second team foul.
Huerter Herter against Westbrook. Outside Barnes. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Sabonis. That's it. Coming off an assist from Barnes.
Assisted.
Give him eight.
He's been terrific tonight, and with a little help from the other guys on the floor, they might be able to turn this game around.
Kicks it out to Barnes. 4-3. He connects. And now he's 4-for-6 in today's game.
Pretty much not a player in the league is going to pass up a shot like that, so much for the defense.
Herter passes to Lyles. Great D that time from Middleton.
Hard to convert against that kind of defensive pressure.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
He's just an aggressive finisher there inside.
Hey, when you got bounce like that, you feel like you can take on anybody. Now a timeout called by Sacramento.
And one thing I've learned through the years is no matter the situation, there are always adjustments you can make.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
Boucher's checked in for Middleton. Bataze's checked in for Sacramento. Mitchell comes in for Herter. Mitchell, the pass to Bataze. Outside for Mitchell. From the high post, rebounded by Trent. And Barnes has got the ball here for the Raptors. They lead by 20. That's the most we've seen. Here's Turner. And it's Sacramento with the rebound.
Teammates right now covering up for the type of off performance he's having. In terms of scoring, this has not been his best night.
Now here's Monk. 10 points for him. Takes a three. Rebounded by Russell Westbrook.
Well, his shots aren't dropping. And they haven't been able to keep pace, but...
Oh, oh man!
Oh!
He's a living highlight reel.
Seriously, that could end up being one of the best dunks of the year. Sacramento has gone 1-of-2 from deep in the second quarter. Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Good. Mitchell's got 14.
That's been the story of their offense so far, getting a number of looks from point-blank range.
Toronto has gotten 5 of 11 threes to drop so far in this game. Trent outside. It's Barnes on the wing. It's Barnes on the wing. Hits the trifecta. 14 points for him.
And he was dominant in their last outing. And the same thing here tonight. He is in a terrific groove right now.
Seems to be nobody standing in his way. No roadblocks for him to get to his spot, capitalize, and continue to be aggressive.
Now here's Mitchell. 14 points for him. And they call the 8-second violation. Too much time getting it up court. Now we get a chance to check some stats for Chris Middleton. Mitchell against Westbrook. Mitchell, the pass to Monk. Dives for it. Out of bounds. It'll be Toronto's ball. And right here on the 2K leaderboard, the best rebounding teams of the past 10 games. Toronto, number one.
And over the last 10 games, this team has brought it to the glass. Everyone is getting involved and trying to help one another secure boards.
Trent against Monk. And Trent the bucket on the assist by Westbrook. Westbrook's got 5 assists tonight.
And give their offense some love. They've been the more efficient team.
Yeah, that along with maintaining the pace of play. Right now playing with tons of intensity.
Wow! Always fun to see point guards who can elevate above the rim like that.
Oh, a strong mindset and even stronger finish.
Well, just seeking out weaknesses in the defense and then exploiting it.
Being productive. Turner is a constant offensive threat.
The Kings shooting it very well. 52% during the second. Here's Lyles. 23 points for him last game against Memphis. Boom! He jams it straight down.
Woo! Not a lot of resistance from the D.
That's the last guy you want to leave open.
Well, not that wide open. You're given a juicy gift by the defense. You got to sink your teeth into it.
Goga Bitadze. First personal foul, Second team.
And some changes here for the Kings. Noel, he's checked in for Lyles. Keegan Murray comes in for Barnes. And it's Dorte in for Monk. Here's Dorte. No points so far. To the middle. Here's Noel. And Noel hammers it down.
And he's playing the game with a certain flair right now.
Oh, he caps off the move with a little hang time on the rim. Now here's Boucher. And here's LeVert for three. Nails it from beyond the arc. LeVert's gotten his third basket of the night.
Hard to win games when you allow clean looks from the perimeter.
Pass to Bataze. McDaniels against Murray. Banked it in off the glass. Murray's got his first points in this one.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint. I'm not sure what's happened to their defense, man.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Outside McDaniels. Right through the D for the layup. And here are the Kings now. After this game, they can look forward to Washington, where they'll match up against the Wizards. That'll be their second of three games total on this road trip.
There are only a few players in the league who can hit a teammate like that in stride. Beautiful assist.
Offensive board. And terrific work on the offensive glass as he picks up the deuce.
Such a big part of what he does for this team. Just work and work on the boards, generate second chance opportunities, and hopefully convert.
Here's Duarte. Yet to see a basket. LeVert outside. Here's Schroeder. Here's Barnes. Oh, it's blocked. It deflects off the backboard. Pass to Murray. Fires the three. Gets it to go. That makes him two for three in this game.
And they're in a better flow this quarter offensively. And their shooting percentage is steadily rising as a result.
And that one's good.
All the way to the bucket. No resistance. Just swipe the candy from him.
Now here's Mitchell. 16 points for him. Stolen by Schroeder. It's a one-on-one situation. Pass to Boucher. Down the pipe it goes. Schroeder with the assist. Schroeder's got his fourth assist with that last one. Sacramento has gone 2 of 4 from the perimeter in the second so far. Here's Bataze. Over Boucher. That one rolls around and rims out.
That's pretty much the only way to keep him from taking advantage of you down low. You got to play tough, physical defense.
Basket counts.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
And the Kings shooting about 47%. A nice number. The three from Mitchell. And it's Boucher with the rebound. Outside Schroeder. Pass to LeVert. Three-pointer. Oh, and the buzzer beater is good.
It just nails the three. Way to close the quarter.
Boy, you love nailing the last second shot. Always a feel-good moment.
And so a pretty lopsided game through the first half. Delivering the blowout. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out there for the start of the third quarter, right after the break.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. For the Raptors, Kenny, how'd you see it?
They were in such a groove that entire first half, especially on the offensive end. Good play calling, good execution, and by and large, they take good, not good, great shots.
And Shaq, what do you think about Sacramento?
I know teams love to rely on the three these days, but you got to know when to get away. They did, at least throughout the first half. Hopefully they're making the adjustments, but sometimes teams just get stubborn.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side,
my brother.
Just about ready for the second half here. A big comeback is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Scotty Barnes with a strong contribution so far in this one.
Can they come up with an answer for him coming out of the half? They have to change something defensively.
Yeah, just way too easy out there, and I'm sure Coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. We've got Barnes. Dennis Schroeder is out there with Chris Boucher. Then there's Miles Turner, and it's Middleton in at the three spot. That's the group starting the second half for Darko Rajakovic. Now here's Monk. Pass to Sabonis. Here's Bataze, covered by Schroeder, and Bataze gets it to go.
If you leave someone open on a team with Sabonis having the ball, he's going to make you pay. That's great recognition.
And it's Middleton finishing it off.
That's why you keep your head up. If the assist is there, you can pounce.
Here are the Kings with the ball now. Here's Bataze, pass to Monk. Now here's Barnes. Drains the triple. Barnes has got 9 points.
All kinds of ways Barnes can hurt you with the basketball. He's sneaky fast with that release.
Middleton from the outside. It's rebounded by Bataze. Bataze's got 4 rebounds now. Stolen by Middleton. And it's Middleton finishing it off.
A coast-to-coast for Chris Middleton, finding some room and weaving his way for a deuce.
Here's Monk. Out to Sabonis. Tries yet again. And it's Boucher with the rebound. Boucher's got his 4th rebound in this one. Barnes finds Schroeder. That's in. Coming off an assist from Barnes. Barnes has got 7 assists in the game.
Watching Schroeder put the team on his back has been entertaining, and he's scoring at a steady clip.
Woo!
Malik.
B.A., that's lit.
Ferocious all the way. Man, that was good. Here's Barnes. Good. 8 buckets in 12 attempts.
And you know Coach loves seeing his offense operate at this level. Great passing out there.
Outside Barnes. Pass to Lyles. Here's Sabonis. Second chance effort. And that one, good. 10 points for him.
And Sabonis with the reward there for the hustle, picking up the scraps.
Here's Schroeder. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Monk's got 5 rebounds in the game. Here's Bataze. They get the rebound. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in.
Now, what's the saying? Don't box out. You get your feelings hurt.
Here's Schroeder. And it goes. That makes it 9 for 13 now.
They're playing great team basketball. It's good movement and sharp, crisp passing.
Now Barnes. 9 points in the game from 10 feet away. Sabonis can't hit.
And it's amazing. Their slim advantage on the board seems a lot larger than it is.
Pass to Boucher. Back to Middleton. Fires from deep. Knocks it down from distance. Middleton's got 7 now in this quarter.
What a performance on the offensive end. He's making the defenders pay right now for all of the mistakes they're making.
Oh, they get a hand on it. Oh, stolen by Turner. And he scores it. Now 5 of 9 from the field.
Yeah, good awareness from Turner and an excellent job coming away with the steal.
Inside, here's Sabonis. And Sabonis slams it in.
That's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference. Not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Now here's Turner. He's got 10. The 3 from Barnes. That shot is off. For Sacramento, they've gotten 6 of 11 attempts to fall so far in the third. Barnes, no good. For Toronto, they've gotten 8 of 11 shots to go in. Efficient so far in the third. Barnes, no good. Sacramento has gone 1 of 2 shooting from the perimeter since halftime. Ooh, poked away. Stolen by Schroeder. the floater. Oh, Sabonis with a block.
Sabonis has to use good timing in order to block shots. That time he did.
And Chris Middleton gets the whistle that time. That's foul number two for him. Herter's checked in for the Kings. All right, let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Brian, on any given night, you can see NBA stars put up huge point totals. Clippers coach Ty Lue said, quote, when you have those big explosive scoring nights, guys are getting to the free throw line and teams are encouraging them to take three-point shots. So if you get hot and you make some, you can score a lot of points. Brian?
That all adds up, doesn't it, Allie? Thanks for that. Here's Trent following the score by Sacramento. And that one comes off the assist by Westbrook. Trent's got 16 points.
Love his shot selection. Good at taking quality shots. Whether he's defended or open, he knows how to knock those down.
It's stolen by Poeltl. In transition. Westbrook, the pass to Poeltl. And here's Turner. Let's the three fly. And that bucket makes him 6-for-10 in the contest. All right, guys, a breakdown here of the hustle stats for Toronto.
Their defensive intensity has served them well. It kept the offense scrambling and resulted in several steals.
Well, if we add another thing to it, it's about the urgency they played with. I mean, you look at the eyes of these guys. They're focused, wanting to get up tempo, and that's helped them score on the fast break.
And Chris Middleton gets the whistle that time. That's his third foul of the game.
And just a great job of getting there first and absorbing the contact.
Young, he's checked in for Toronto. Caris LeVert comes in for Middleton. Knocked loose. And it's out of bounds to Sacramento.
Sacramento ball.
On Friday, they'll be matching up with Victor Oladipo and the Oklahoma City Thunder. Then on Saturday, they kick off a road trip in Washington, where they'll take on the Wizards.
And that game against Brooklyn. Anything can happen in the NBA, but they'll be a heavy favorite, and it would take a total meltdown for them to lose.
Now here's Monk. He's got 14. Damn, that one's good. Give him 8 points now.
Well, the anticipation for steals that Westbrook shows, I mean, maybe playing point guard paying off on the defensive end to help create that fast break.
Here's Herter. Looking to end the run. Poeltl grabs a miss. Poeltl's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
First personal foul. First team foul.
The Kings have gone 50% from the field in the third quarter. 8 of 16. Well, Brent, you got to be impressed with Kevin Herter, specifically how efficient he is.
Yeah, there's a completeness to his game that I think coaches appreciate. It's not just that Kevin's a knockdown shooter. He's able to handle the ball, manipulate pick and rolls, and he continues to show that he's got some improvement and room to grow.
And finished off by Westbrook.
Oh, nice ball movement by LeVert. A welcome sign for this team.
Sacramento has gone only 1 of 3 from deep here in the third. Here's Duarte. He's checked by LeVert. Monk passes to Herter. That one goes. Count it.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
Personal foul.
Shooting. And coach doesn't like the call at all. He's opting to use his challenge. He wants the officials to look at the replay. McDaniels is checked in for Trent. The Kings also with a sub. Mitchell's checked in for Monk.
And even with the coach's challenge in place, we've seen so many of these personal foul calls still disputed even after the video review.
There's no doubt there's going to be a gray area in a lot of these calls. But at least we have the option to take a second look so the officials can be sure they get it right. So they see clear evidence of a bad call, and they're going to overturn it. Probably the right decision.
And give credit to the officials for recognizing the mistake and correcting it. Nobody likes to say they got it wrong, but they fixed it in a hurry.
And so it's Westbrook who will bring it up for Toronto. Good, and that makes him 6-for-9. A quality game for him so far.
So challenging for anybody, not just guards, to match Westbrook and his physicality.
Here's Noel. And Young pulls it down.
Perfect timing to rise up and challenge the shot inside.
Yeah, not easy to do there. And that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Everything is dropping for them. Just a terrific third period run.
Well, with the confidence growing, that's one thing, but they seem to be getting more intense, and that's helping the quality of their play here.
Here's Pirtle. Count it.
Their offense has been unstoppable, just firing on all cylinders.
I mean, this team is just dangerous. Right now, every shot that they're putting up feels like it's going in.
Now here's Mitchell. 16 points for him. Pass to Murray. Now here's Noel. It's stolen by Pirtle. And they're running. On up the court. McDaniels. That's good.
McDaniels
got eight.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
Mitchell against Westbrook. Murray with it. Over Pirtle. Oh, rejected by Pirtle. Outside Young. To the paint. McDaniels. That one's good. And it's Young with the assist. He's got 10.
Strong pass there to set up the basket.
Sacramento has gone only one of three from deep here in the third. From deep, Mitchell. Pirtle grabs a miss. Pirtle's got rebound number 7 tonight. Pass to LeVert. To the right side. Pirtle, the pass to Young. It's McDaniels on the wing. Three-pointer off the mark. And pushing it up, here's Sacramento. And Mitchell with the slam.
Mitchell. And really showing the athleticism, flying solo.
Yeah, why not? Show a little creativity, get inside, move that ball around, just make sure you score.
The shot by LeVert, no good. Sacramento shooting an impressive 48% from the floor in the third quarter. Herter from long range. Ooh, give him his fifth make of the game in 10 attempts.
Well, the defense very attentive to him in the first quarter, but he's finally gotten loose in the second and making them pay.
Very little resistance around the rim right now. That's the fifth straight bucket they've given up in the paint.
2 minutes remaining.
Pass to Duarte.
2 minutes.
.151 left in the third quarter here. Ooh, LeVert with some nice D. Now Pirtle. And here's Westbrook. Checked by Mitchell. From downtown, Westbrook with the miss.
His teammates cannot be happy with him, guys. He would have been better off resetting the offense and looking for a better shot opportunity.
And they get it back.
Hard work on the glass gives them back the ball. And they get to milk a little clock here.
Great to have Noel active like that, proving how dangerous he can be on the inside.
Pass to LeVert. It's LeVert on the wing. Launches a three. McDaniels, that's good. McDaniels got 15. 102 left in the third quarter. Westbrook against Mitchell. Outside Herter. Pirtle with the block. And they get it back. And they're pushing it up. McDaniels passes to Pirtle. Kicks it out to Westbrook. McDaniels from long range. Here's Pirtle. And good work on the boards as they picked up the second chance points. Pirtle's got 4 points now in the quarter. Sacramento has gone 2 of 6 from downtown here in the second half. Outside Mitchell. And he lobs it up, and Noel hammers it down.
Great teamwork and great timing.
Oh, spectacular play. Left side McDaniels. Oh, a nice one-handed slam right there.
I guess you don't need two hands when one will suffice.
Hey, as long as you don't lose control. And so it's Toronto, and they're up an insane amount going into the break. Their efficiency has been off the charts. They're running their sets well with patience and purpose. And more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way right after this. and a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
You talk about painting a magnificent picture with that dime. Just a great decision and a perfect delivery.
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. All right, a look at the five for the Kings to start the fourth quarter. Nerlens Noel out there with Alex Lynn. Then it's Chris Duarte. Then there's Edwards. And it's Jones in at the shooting guard position.
In order to create effective spacing, you need enough guys on the floor that can hit from downtown.
And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. Well, Grant, with his size and range, Grady Dick is a ready-made floor spacer.
Oh, this kid is lights out shooting the ball, B.A. Such a threat to defenses. You can't lose track of him. He's always moving around the floor.
And even the players have expressed concern about load management. Are changes afoot, or is this the new normal, Grant?
Well, B.A., I think protecting players from injury is smart to do. But maybe the ticket sellers need to highlight the back-to-back game so fans are well aware that some players might be sitting. Shooting through contact, Grady Dick has a compact release that holds up well.
Here's Duarte, covered by Schroeder. Lynn is good.
Of all the action happening there, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the Buckeyes.
Come on, B.A. He sure can rise.
Grant, that's as good as it gets. One of the best in the league. Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. And here's Jones. Pass to Duarte. Takes the three. McDaniels with the rebound.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Into the lane.
Nice idea by Grady Dick. I mean, he put the ball on the floor, and I think that'll open things up for him.
We've gone about a minute and a half into this fourth quarter. Outside Jones. And it's out of bounds to Sacramento. Middleton has checked in for McDaniels.
Checking in for Toronto, Chris Middleton.
Edwards, a pass to Duarte. Here's Lynn. Kept alive. And that one is stuffed right through.
This guy's got a great nose for the offensive glass, and I like how he used those long arms that time to reach up, snag that rebound.
Jones from outside. Oh, almost had a four-point play right there. But he'll go to the line with a chance for three.
First team foul.
Ooh, good defensive intensity. But you have to stay in control always.
And you look at how screens are set in today's game. Brent, the screeners get away with a lot.
B.A., you could call them legal screen on almost every pick and roll now. There's a lot of leaning. There's a lot of moving. Guys are extended outside of their body with their feet. But offenses, they greatly benefit from the way the game is called, and they'll continue to take advantage of it.
Miles Turner, he's checked in for Toronto. Boucher comes in for Young. And he nails the third. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth here. Middleton passes to Dick. And that comes off the assist by Middleton. Middleton's got four assists now tonight.
Feeling more and more comfortable in this offense. That's just Chris Middleton making a play.
Toronto foul. Grady Dick. First personal foul. Second team foul. Into the lineup for your Raptors. Scotty Barnes. Gary Trent Jr.
Got a piece of it, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Westbrook. Bitaze's checked in for Lynn.
In for the Kings, Goga Bitaze.
Here's Noel. Here's Edwards. Laid it in with a nice touch off the window.
That's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense, a quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in.
Here's Middleton. Score that basket. His eighth out of nine shots here today.
Great signs to see Chris Middleton have this kind of offensive output.
Outside Jones. Driving in. And he jams it home with authority.
Oh, my God. That was impressive. How many guys can flush it like this man?
Not many. That's for sure. He can really fly.
And the defense knows this. Somebody has to come over to contest.
And when you've got your opponent down, you don't want to take your foot off the pedal.
This is what great players try to do. They're not allowing the opposition to gain any kind of hope to try and get back in the game.
And they're plus +5 on the boards after that rebound.
Barnes drives in. And the shot goes in. Barnes has got 21.
These defenders really need to man up, particularly in the lane.
Pass to Jones. Here's Bataze. Turner covers. And Bataze gets it to go.
Say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
Now here's Turner. The three from Barnes. Sacramento grabs the miss. Bataze's got his 7th rebound here tonight.
Well, he got off to a terrific start from the perimeter, but in the second half, he can't seem to build on that early success.
He was grabbing the rim to extend the hang time.
Hey, maybe making sure the landing was kinder than the takeoff. Barnes, it's good.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
The Kings have gotten 7 of their first 10 shots to go during this fourth quarter. Pass to Bataze. Under the new collective bargaining agreement, the all-NBA teams will now be positionless. What do you think about that, Brent?
Yeah, I love it. I mean, you're awarding the players that had the best seasons, and if it happens to be guard-heavy or big-heavy or wing-heavy, so be it. The 15 best players are going to get the acknowledgement that all the hard work and all the consistency and what they put into the season, that's going to pay off.
Tipped away. Stolen by Middleton. Here's Barnes. Finished off the break. Barnes has got 6 points in the quarter.
I just love how he runs the floor with energy and intensity, but still stays under control.
Yeah, you think he's comfortable at that speed? He's done it so many times before. Just an absolute blur in transition. And that helps get the rhythm going. That's pretty much not how they want to defend the three-point line. Somebody's got to shadow him out there.
There's the triple. Jones grabs the board. And so it's Jones who brings up the ball for the Sacramento Kings. The rebound by Turner. Turner's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Barnes passes to Westbrook. Middleton outside. The three is up. That one's good. And it's Barnes with the assist. Barnes has got assist number 8 here already in the game. Sacramento has gone 2 of 3 from beyond the arc here in the fourth. Jones, the pass to Bataze. And a two-handed jam!
Oh, that was nasty. A two-hand mega slam.
Man, I don't think anyone was going to stop him there. Pass to Barnes. And it's stolen by Noel. Edwards, a pass to Duarte. Another shot. The shot comes out. Excellent D there from Westbrook.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
Right side Barnes. Here's the three. They get it back. Trent on the wing. Back to Turner. Kicks it out to Middleton. Turner passes to Westbrook. The three from Barnes, counted from distance. Barnes has got 11 points here in the second half.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
Here's Duarte. Pass to Jones. Grant, you look at the league's basketball-related income. The players and owners split it about 50-50.
You know, BA, that's why they call it a partnership. You talk about a shared interest. The NBA has really become a leader by example in all of professional sports.
Middleton from the outside. That's it. Coming off an assist from Barnes. Middleton's got 10 points now, just in this quarter. And the Kings shooting about 48% from the floor. Pretty good. Jones against Trent. Pass to Duarte. From deep. Barnes with the rebound. Barnes has got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
They've been very well-rounded and extremely focused.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
Jones misses.
They really have a commanding lead, not just in points, but in rebounds as well.
And Barnes with the basket. The assist from Trent. Barnes has got 32 points in the game.
He's putting on a show this quarter, and the team's feeding off his energy.
Trent against Jones. Outside Edwards. Drops in the three.
Zero defense. You can't let a good shooter have the wide open three.
Barnes passes to Middleton. Here's Westbrook. And Westbrook slams it home.
I'll tell you what, it's good to be his age.
Yeah, I don't have memories like that at my age, though. Sacramento has gone 3 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the third quarter. Here's Duarte, pounded by Westbrook. Duarte, pass to Noel. And Noel hammers it down.
B.A., the one-hand dunk just looks so fluid.
Yeah, absolutely. Even smooth when he's powering it home like that.
Perfect timing to rise up and challenge the shot inside.
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
And, yep, it's good.
Boy, absolutely no rim protection, leading to a lot of easy buckets here.
Jones against Trent. And the foul on Gary Trent. That's his first foul of the game. And as general manager of the Austin Spurs, how important is the G League when it comes to player development, Brent?
Well, it's such a learning ground, B.A., for everybody. Not just the players, but the coaching staff, the training staff, even game ops people that want to put the proper show on for the fans that show up to see the game. But for the players specifically, it gives them great experience that they're not going to get while in the NBA sitting on the bench somewhere. They're on the floor, they're getting great coaching, and they're developing their skills every day. So that G for us stands for growth.
Young against Monk. Shoots over Young. Again, the Kings score! 1:49 left to play in the fourth quarter. Trent from long range. Oh, he can't miss. 8 for 8 after that shot.
Just incredible. I mean, he's really making it rain out there, knocking them down one after another.
Kind of like he's in his living room right now. He's found a comfort zone. Once he gets that, the defense knows they're in trouble.
Here's Vitase. Over Young. Second shot opportunity. They get it again. Vitase, the pass to Noel. And it's Monk off the drive. This one for three. And it's Mitchell, the miss. Toronto's gone 4 of 8 from three-point land during the fourth. Back to Trent. And the foul on Gary Trent. That'll be a second foul of the game.
And great job to establish position and square up.
McDaniels has checked in for Middleton. Sacramento has gone 3 of 6 from downtown so far in the fourth. Mitchell against Schroeder. Pass to Monk. There's 47 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. How about the unselfishness of this team?
Yeah, the willingness to make the next pass has this defense scrambling. You got to give them respect. They're doing everything they can to close this out.
Love that the guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
Here's Vitase. He can't hit that time. Young with the defensive effort. They've got a commanding lead.
It just seems like everything is going their way.
3-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Schroeder. uses the glass to finish the layup.
Impressive job by this team. And you really can't discount the impact of this crowd here.
Awesome to see their output tonight, trying to urge their team on. And that can always help. That home advantage of home fans getting you going, fully on display here.
And so they get the victory here at home, showing that they're the far superior team. They win it going away.
I'll tell you what, give it up for their fans. They love to watch this team dominate. And you best believe they're all going home happy tonight.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. So long, everybody.